With most MPs now sworn in by the Chief Justice Mogoeng, it's now down to the business of electing the Speaker of the National Assembly. The ANC benches have put Thandi Modise's name forward for the position. And the DA has put its own candidate forward. The opposition party nominated Thembekile Majola, and this has prompted the sitting to be adjourned to prepare for a secret ballot vote. The Deputy Speaker is yet to be elected, and with that concluded, it will be the nomination of the President. Leader of the majority party, the ANC, Cyril Ramaphosa, is expected to take that position. Upon election as President, Ramaphosa will have to resign as a Member of Parliament. His deputy will be Leader of Government Business in Parliament. But with the postponement of David Mabuza's swearing-in, it remains to be seen how the ANC will move beyond this point.
And here's some detail on who wasn't sworn in today. Two of the ANC's top leaders withdrew their names on the list of MPs to be sworn in today. ANC National Working Committee member Nomvula Mokonyane has withdrawn from Parliament as House Chairperson. The ANC has confirmed that a new House Chairperson will be deployed. Mokonyane has stated that due to family responsibilities and her being in mourning, she would be unable to fulfill her duties at this stage. Meanwhile, the ANC says the postponement of the swearing-in of the party's Deputy President David Mabuza as an MP is not linked to whether or not he will be part of the next cabinet. Mabuza has requested that his swearing-in be postponed until allegations against him have been dealt with within the party's integrity commission. Head of the presidency in the ANC, Zizi Godwa, says the party commends Mabuza's decision but has reiterated that this has nothing to do with factions within the ruling party. Mabuza has been named in a number of scandals, including allegations of being behind political killings in Mpumalanga. Well, for more on this story, we cross to our reporter, Bulelani Philip, who is standing by for us in Parliament.
Well, welcome to Parliament. We are still continuing to bring you this special broadcast of the swearing-in of members of Parliament. Of course, there hasn't been much happening this morning other than the smooth process of swearing in all the members of the National Assembly. Well, one of the issues that I did see that seemed to be a hiccup, one of the members actually forgot his form for taking his oath of office. Of course, also the ANC and the DA incorrectly filling in the forms of nominating their preferred candidates to be the Speaker. As we stand now, the issue is lunch as Parliament prepares to, you know, prepare ballot papers as well as bringing in voting booths so that after lunch, the election of the Speaker, Deputy Speaker, as well as the President can resume without any hitches. Of course, we are continuing to take political reaction right here on the steps of the National Assembly. The EFF walking in with a voucher led by the CIC of the EFF, Mr. Julius Malima. Tell us about that. Was that your theme for this morning?
Well, we were celebrating the mandate given to our people. We did say that we receive warmly that mandate and we commit not to disappoint. And we were saying to our enemies, we have arrived. 44 battalion member is inside the National Assembly and will continue to keep members of Parliament awake, particularly those old ones of the ANC.
From 25 to 44 seats, of course, what can we expect from you in this 6th Parliament? Is it going to be the same way that you carried yourself in the 5th Parliament, or is it going to be different?
We're continuing the same way, robust, speaking truth to power, holding the executive accountable and making sure that the teeth of Parliament do bite when it is necessary. So we are here to make sure that this Parliament is not just useless, but hold everyone accountable. We are not going to conform with things that seek to defend the corruption of the ruling party.
Of course, the ANC announcing a new presiding officers on Monday. You've had a personal confrontation with the Speaker-elect, Ms. Thandi Modise, previously. As the EFF, what's your impression of the presiding officers-elect that have been chosen by the ANC?
Well, we think that when you compare Thandi Modise with the previous Speaker, Balega Mbete, she's the most reasonable person. She's seasoned. She's a woman of substance. And she's able to rise above political party pettiness, and with hope that when elected, she will do the right thing. She will not succumb to the party pressure to a point where she wants to turn this parliament into a mouthpiece of the ANC.
Now let's look at some of the ANC members that have been on their list deciding not to come to parliament this morning at the 11th hour. Of course, there are also those perhaps maybe you have issues with that remain members of parliament. Your way of treating them come this sixth parliament?
Well, all those who are accused of corruption, we think that they don't deserve to be in this parliament. All of them should have recused themselves until they've cleared their names. But South Africans should not be fooled by the stance of the Deputy President Thandi Modise. Thandi Modise is not going to accept to be a member of parliament for as long as there is no assurance that he will be re-elected as a deputy, reappointed rather, as a deputy president. Because if he accepts being a member of parliament and he doesn't get appointed deputy president, he loses all the benefits because his last position is a member of parliament. There is no conscience there. It's an issue of opportunism where he wants to defend his benefits. Once appointed deputy president, he will be sworn in and he will know that all his benefits are now safe.
Mr. Malema, thank you so much for your time. Julius Malema, he is the Commander-in-Chief of the Economic Freedom Fighters. Of course, I'm going to bring into this conversation now the spokesperson of the DA, Mr. Soli Malatsi. Of course, you know that they've actually fielded a candidate to oppose the nomination of the ANC for the Speaker's position. Mr. Malatsi, thank you so much for joining us. The reasoning behind fielding your own candidate, given that you don't have the necessary numbers?
Yeah, absolutely. We are presenting an alternative to members of the House because we believe that we've got a credible candidate. He's the former Speaker of the Western Cape Provincial Parliament. He's a returning Member of Parliament with a second term. But we know that given, you know, the tenures of previous speakers, particularly in the last term, where we had a very biased speaker, that it is key that we present an alternative to the members of parliament in the House so that they can exercise their right to choose whomsoever they feel that will be impartial, will be fair, and will execute the rules fairly across all different parties.
In 2014, you fielded Nosimo Palindlela, the former Eastern Cape Premier. Now you're fielding Richard Matjola. Is there any coincidence that you're fielding people of color in this position, given that you know maybe the numbers are not on your side?
Absolutely not. I mean, if we are talking about someone who stands the strongest chance of fulfilling the role of the speaker fairly well because of the experience they had in our caucus, Richard Matjola is the logical conclusion. As I said earlier on, he spent 5 years as the speaker in the Western Cape Provincial Parliament, not very far from here. And it was a hectic parliament because it was the first time the ANC was also in opposition. So we believe that, you know, he's a person who will stand up to the office, and that's why we forwarded him as a candidate.
All right, thank you so much. Soli Malatsi, he is the spokesperson of the Democratic Alliance. We wish him all the best this afternoon as they vote for the positions of Speaker, as well as Deputy Speaker, as well as the President. I'm not sure whether they will be fielding a candidate for that. We were hoping to speak to the leader of GOOD, Patricia Delil, but of course she is being swabbed by some of the media here. But we will obviously try and bring it to you later this afternoon. On that note, we'll come back to you guys in studio.
Thank you to my colleague there, Bulelani Philip, in Parliament.